A very good morning to one and all. On behalf of Amity University Rajasthan, I extend a very hearty welcome to all participants of the International Conference on Global Entrepreneurship Trends and Empowerment Through Innovation. There have been some very innovative and insightful papers presented yesterday, which I'm sure will be of immense benefit to all the participants. In fact, all these international conferences do have the inherent advantage to serve as a confluence of ideas which tend to diffuse in their own ways. Herein, the conference is unique to focus on innovation as a driver for global entrepreneurship and empowerment. It provides a forum to diverse stakeholders in its endeavor to bring together cross-disciplinary deliberations to forge its future trajectory. This technical session covers the theme addressed in Track 2 and Track 4, which focus on the themes of entrepreneurship and innovation and social business and innovation respectively. The linkages between the themes of entrepreneurship and innovation in Track 2 are reflected in this memorable quote by Watts Humphrey, and I quote, "Innovation is the process of turning ideas into manufacturable and marketable form," which is what defines entrepreneurship in simple terms. On the other hand, converting of innovative ideas to drive social change implicitly requires an understanding of linkages between innovation and social business, a theme which is being focused on in Track 4. We have had excellent speakers yesterday who had presented their insights on these themes that promise to be of immense value to all participants. These participants, which could be students, researchers, faculty members, industry leaders, etc., can surely be envisaged in the role of potential entrepreneurs, innovators, and social change makers. To continue to provide an erudite declamation on these very significant themes that were also discussed and deliberated yesterday, please join me in welcoming our esteemed keynote speaker for this session, Mr. Ashish Goswami. Mr. Goswami is presently a business unit head at Infintech Exim Private Limited and has had a rich professional experience of 25 years that includes diverse functions in varied industry segments. Mr. Goswami has had a rich experience in business development, administration, distribution, key account management, channel management, operations, sales and marketing, corporate, vendor, customer relationship management in varied industry segments such as pharma and telecom, etc. He has been associated in the recent past with glorious companies like Reliance Jio, Apple, Samsung, Alcatel, TCL, and HTC, etc. He is well known for his strong know-how in managing of the operations, corporate and vendor relations, planning, sales, marketing, and development of businesses and technologies, overall planning of the activities, resources, budgets, operations of a professional profit center, and you name it, and we can see that he's had different key functions in diverse industry segments. So with his expertise in such diverse domains and industry segments, we keenly look forward to his wise words. So without taking any more time, may I now invite Mr. Ashish Goswami for presenting his keynote address, please?
Well, I'll start my session. So, we'll start talking about startup. As an idea, startup is a group of experiments to find a solution to a problem and creating a sustainable and scalable business model around it. In raw terms, a startup can be a company working to solve a problem where the solution is not obvious and the success is also not guaranteed. I'll name some not so encouraging facts about startups, specifically speaking about the Indian market. 90% of the startups fail, which means that only 1 in 10 of the startups will survive through its journey. About 21.5% of startups fail in the first year of their existence, next 30% in their second year, and almost about 50% of these startups close down in the fifth year. following which 70% in their 10th year. 75% of venture-backed startups fail. So now we will discuss something. Why do the startups fail in India? The first and the foremost point why the startups fail in India is the lack of uniqueness of the idea. Lack of an innovative and unique Indian market-specific business model. Well, in the recent past, maybe in the last decade, almost all the startups were focusing on the Western business models and replicating those models into India. But India is a very specific market, and all the new startups must have innovations which meet the requirements of the specific Indian market requirements. Then the third point, why the startups fail in India, and well, this point may be valid for all the startups across the globe, is the lack of financial resources. Even the lack or the delay in getting finances. Many startups in India, without having adequate gross margin, go on expanding their business by giving heavy discounts in deals. They don't build long-term plans for a source of profit to cover their profit margin and acquire the market. In the quest of selling at lower price, they keep on compromising with their gross margin and end up being bankrupt. Another most important reason behind the failure of startups in India is the negative cash flow and the negative working capital. Continuous cash flow is necessary to run any business, including the startups. Even if the book of accounts is showing a profit, delaying payment may hurt your working capital to continue the operations. In the absence of adequate working capital, owing to delay in cash inflow, you start searching for funds to continue the business, which after some level fades away in investors' trust in you. Financial challenges faced up by the startups in India may also include that in India, we have got very few angel investors. There is a high rate of interest of the private institutions for funding. Basically, a big shortage, a big gap in the number of startup incubators and accelerators. Mostly the startup incubators and accelerators are located, situated in bigger or metro cities in India only. A lot of paperwork is required for acquiring government scheme loans, etc. from government banks. Then comes the part of marketing in building up your startup. So a poor marketing mix can also hamper and result in failure of the startup. Certainly, a very genuine point is an incompetent team, which also is a major factor in the failure of startups. Well, a startup is a very initial organization and it's always having a very small team. The team must be on the same page. The team must be equally dedicated towards the goal of the founder of the startup. The whole team should share the same concept, what is being looked by the startup. And it's very difficult to maintain this whole system in the initial stages of a startup. The next point is the lack of customer-centric approach. Engagement of new customers, but failure in customer retention, which leads to non-scalability of recurring revenue model. We'll move on to the next slide. Well, I will quote some studies and the results about the reasons of failures of startups. The first and the most, the biggest contributor of failure in startups is that the product does not have any market. Does not have market means it does not have any demand, or this product is not useful for the customer. This contributes to the 40% of the share why the why the startups fail. Lack of finances and cash flow results in failure of 30% startups. An incompetent and demotivated team results in 23% of the startups getting failed. Due to incorrect product price mix, 18% of the startups fail. Product not meeting customer expectations or the market expectations also results in 17% of the failure of startups. Poor marketing, another 14%, and due to all of the above, the loss of investor interest contributes about 8% of the failure of startups. So well, in the last few minutes, what we were talking about the startups, their failures, their reasons of the failures, the challenges which the startup is going to face in India, or the startups which are existing are already facing, are identification of a unique product or process. This does not mean replication of Western ideas or Western startups. Innovation is a very important factor, which we'll be discussing later also. Funding, financing is a big challenge in India, and in contemporary times, in recent times, in post-COVID-19 scenario also, funding and financing are the very most stiff challenges which the startups are going to face. Then developing a correct business and revenue model will also be a big challenge in the coming times. Once again, manpower dependence, marketing mix, competition, these all are universal challenges. So now moving to the importance of innovation. To create value means to innovate. I'll basically put some points into innovation. First and foremost will be the employee innovation. Employee innovation, to build a full innovation ecosystem, organizations must start with employee innovation programs. Organizations cannot scale innovation outside until they start from within. The same employee who are building products, servicing customers, and making sure that day-to-day operations of the company are sound are the same employees that can come up with game-changing ideas or identify new opportunities and threats. Customer innovation is a very crucial aspect for organization. It's crucial for organizations to extend beyond their four walls when looking at innovation. When opening to customer innovation, the organization receives more ideas, comments, feedbacks. It's crucial to start with employee innovation to build out the proper infrastructure to receive, manage, implement, communicate ideas to a customer base. Partner supplier innovation. Organizations work with alliances with suppliers and partners. By opening information and innovating with suppliers and partners, both parties tend to win. Suppliers and partners can offer better products and services to customers, while organizations are able to improve forecasting while reducing wasted resources and time spent. Competitor innovation is also a very important factor. Competition or innovating with competitors is perhaps the most challenging type of innovation. Although this can be hardest model to embrace, it can also be the most rewarding and impactful. Innovating with competitors doesn't have a secret formula. It starts with a conversation and evolves from there. There is no magic pill or framework to follow that will guarantee success. Public innovation. Public innovation programs. The organization need to have a robust set of technology and processes in place to manage the thousands of ideas that come their way. Getting ideas isn't always the hard part. Being able to go from an idea to a product or service can sometimes be far more challenging. Well, further, through innovation ecosystems, we can build upon business ecosystems. A business ecosystem is a network of organizations, including suppliers, distributors, competitors, customers, government regulatory organizations, and many more, which are involved in delivery of a specific product or service through both competition and cooperation. Ecosystems create strong barriers to entry for new competition, as the existing ecosystem already consists of the players that allow it to function. Being part of a business ecosystem provides mechanism to leverage technology, achieve excellence in research and business competence, and compete against large companies. There are science-based ecosystems. Science-based ecosystems are geared towards the front end of the idea conversion cycle. It is created and captured by building critical mass when pushing the scientific frontier in an applied field. Semiconductors and the life sciences, pharmaceuticals, biotechs, medical devices are a few of the examples of the science-based ecosystems. Coming over to technology-based ecosystems focus on idea conversion and innovation adoption. To create value, they should leverage the power of collaboration by connecting with suppliers and companies in complementary business and stimulate the fast adoption of innovation. Consumer electronics, telecom, high-tech automobiles and machinery, examples of technology-based ecosystems. Then we come over to the last service-based ecosystems. Service-based ecosystems are oriented towards solution adoption. Innovation in solutions. Their key role is to provide for asset optimization. Banks, insurance companies, engineering firms, etc. are a few examples of service-based ecosystems. So with this, I would like to conclude my session.